Good morning. All right. We're going to meditate together for about 45 minutes. And then I'm going to read one of the teachings of the Buddha. Meditation. Ding. And so this morning, one of my favorite suttas. It was one of my favorite suttas when I was in the monastery. I remember the first time I read it, I liked it very much. And then it became even more one of my favorites when I moved to Almeria. Because in Spain, I mean the caves in Spain. Because it reminded me so much of there. It reminded me so much of Almeria. And this little neighborhood near the caves called La Jolla, which is like one of these drug dealing hubs of Europe. And they would all tell me, not only me, all of us, don't go there. Why are you staying there? And, oh, we'll see. If you only will know this sutta already, it's from the Majjhima Nikaya. It's called Advice to Punna. Thus I have heard, on one occasion the Buddha was living at Sarvati in Jeta's Grove, Anathapindika's Park. Then, when it was evening, the Venerable Punna rose from meditation and went to see the Buddha. After paying homage to the Buddha, he sat down at one side and said to him, Venerable Sir, it would be good if the Blessed One would give me brief advice. Having heard the Dharma from the Buddha, I will abide alone, withdrawn, diligent, ardent, and resolute. Well then, Punna, said the Buddha, listen and attend carefully to what I shall say. Yes, Venerable Sir, said the Venerable Punna, and the Buddha said this. Punna, there are forms cognizable by the eye that are wished for, desired, and agreeable, and likeable, connected with sensual desire and provocative of lust. If a bhikkhu delights in them, welcomes them, and remains holding to them, delight arises in him. With the arising of delight, Punna, there is the arising of suffering, I say. There are, Punna, sounds cognizable by the ear, odors cognizable by the nose, flavors cognizable by the tongue, tangible objects cognizable by the body, and mind objects cognizable by the mind that are wished for, desired, agreeable and likeable, connected with sensual desire, and provocative of lust. If a bhikkhu delights in them, welcomes them, and remains holding to them, delight arises in him. With the arising of delight, Punna, there is the arising of suffering, I say. Punna, there are forms cognizable by the eye, sounds cognizable by the ear, odors cognizable by the nose, flavors cognizable by the tongue, tangibles cognizable by the body, mind objects cognizable by the mind that are wished for, desired, agreeable, and likable, connected with sensual desire, and provocative of lust. If a bhikkhu does not delight in them, or welcome them, or remain holding to them, delight ceases in him. With the cessation of delight, Punna, there's a cessation of suffering, I say. Now that I've given you this brief advice, Punna, in which country will you dwell? Venerable Sir, now that the Buddha has given me this brief advice, I'm going to dwell in the Sunaparanta country. The people of Sunaparanta are fierce and rough. If they abuse and threaten you, what will you think then? And Punna says, Venerable Sir, if the people of Sunaparanta abuse and threaten me, then I shall think, these people of Sunaparanta are excellent, truly excellent, in that they did not give me a blow with their fist. Then I shall think thus, Buddha, then I shall think thus. But Punna, if the people of Sunaparanta do give you a blow with the fist, what will you think then? And Punna says, Venerable Sir, if the people of Sunaparanta do give me a blow with the fist, then I shall think, these people of Sunaparanta are excellent, truly excellent, in that they did not give me a blow with a clod. Then I shall think thus, Buddha, then I shall think thus. But Punna, if the people of the paradise give you a blow with a clod, what will you think then? Then the Buddha, if the people of Sunaparanta do give me a blow with a clod, then I shall think, these people of Sunaparanta are excellent. They are truly excellent in that they did not give me a blow with a stick. Then I shall think thus, Buddha. Then I shall think thus. But Punna, if the people of Sunaparanta do give you a blow with a stick, what will you think then? Venerable sir, if the people of Sunaparanta do give me a blow with a stick, then I shall think, these people of Sunaparanta are excellent. They are truly excellent in that they did not give me a blow with a knife. Then I shall think thus, Buddha. Then I shall think thus. But Punna, if the people of Sunaparanta do give you a blow with a knife, what will you think then? Venerable sir, if the people of Sunaparanta do give me a blow with a knife, then I shall think, these people of Sunaparanta are excellent, truly excellent, in that they have not taken my life with a sharp knife. Then I shall think thus, Buddha. Then I shall think thus. But Punna, if the people of Sunaparanta do take your life with a sharp knife, what will you think then? Venerable sir, if the people of Sunaparanta do take my life with a sharp knife, then I shall think thus. There have been some students of the Buddha who, having been repelled and humiliated and disgusted by the body and by life itself, have sought for an assailant. But I have obtained this assailant without even having to search for one. Then I shall think thus, Buddha. Then I shall think thus. The Buddha says, good, good, Punna. Possessing such self-control and peacefulness, you will be able to dwell in the Sunaparanta country. Now, Punna, it is time to do as you think fit. Then, having delighted and rejoiced in the Buddha's words, the Venerable Punna rose from his seat, and after paying homage to the Buddha, he departed, keeping him on his right. Then he set his resting place in order, took his bowl and outer robe, and set out to wander towards the Sunaparanta country. Wandering by stages, he eventually arrived in the Sunaparanta country, and there he lived. Then during that rains retreat, the Venerable Punna established 500 men and 500 women in the practice, and he himself realized the three true knowledges. On a later occasion, the Venerable Punna attained final Nibbana. Then a number of bhikkhus went to the Buddha, and after paying homage to him, they sat down at one side and told him, Venerable Sir, the clansman Punna, who was given brief advice by the Buddha, has died. What is his destination? What is his future course? The Buddha says, Bhikkhus, the clansman Punna was wise. He practiced in accordance with the Dhamma and did not trouble me in the interpretation of the Dhamma. The clansman Punna has attained final Nibbana. That is what the Buddha said. The bhikkhus were satisfied and delighted in the Buddha's words. There in that sutta, I feel like we should dedicate that sutta to the people of La Jolla, to the children of La Jolla. Totally different radical view on how to look at abusive behavior. Teachings of the Buddha sometimes revolutionary.